That says the camera's on.
Mom's got an inch on me, and I intend to keep it.
The current emphasis on calcium was largely generated by this May 1984 consensus report by a panel of experts convened by the government. The consensus panel recommended that American women basically double their daily calcium intake from the then average of 550 milligrams per day to between 1,000 and 1,500 milligrams per day. Since the report, there has been an explosion of calcium supplement products.
Add Calcrete to your diet.
That's why there's posture. Now, a new SupplCal calcium supplement can help make a difference.
Dr. William Peck, chairman of the government's consensus panel, points out that ultimately all calcium is the same, but that some forms offer more calcium.
The calcium carbonate salt contains the highest percentage of elemental calcium.
You.
Consequently, you can take fewer pills to get more calcium.
Doing
we recommend
what?
The calcium carbonate.
Calcium carbonate and other forms of calcium are available in various non-prescription products. Some are much costlier than others,
dear.
Often for no good medical reason. Calcium can also be found in certain antacids, like Tums, a benefit not overlooked in their ads.
Great. Tums is rich in calcium. And to me, an extra source of calcium is extra good news.
Despite the panel report and the commercial push for calcium, some experts are not sold. Dr. Bruce Ettinger, an endocrinologist from the University of California in San Francisco, says the case for calcium is